कार्तिक इज द बेस्ट ऑफ द मंथ्स एंड इज वेरी डियर टू लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा. श्रीमती राधा रानी इज द प्रिसाइडिंग डेटी ऑफ दिस मंथ. एनी व्रत ऑब्जर्व इन दिस मंथ विल यील्ड मोर रिजल्ट्स एंड द इफेक्ट ऑफ परफॉर्मिंग सच व्रत विल लास्ट फॉर 100 लाइफ टाइम्स. इन द मंथ ऑफ कार्तिक वन शुड वर्शिप लॉर्ड दामोदर एंड डेली रिसाइड द प्रेयर नोन एज दामोदर अष्टक by Shri Hari Bhakti Vilas. In the Padma Puran, there is a statement that one should perform the ceremonies for the Lord according to one's financial position. Everyone should observe the different ceremonies and celebrations of the Lord by all means. One of the most important of these ceremonial functions is called Urja Vrat, also known as Damodar Vrat, is observed in the month of Kartik, that is, between October and November. Especially in Vrindavan, there is a specific program for temple worship of the Lord in His Damodar form. In Sanskrit, Dam means rope and Udar means belly. Damodar refers to Krishna's being bound with a rope by His mother Yashoda. It is said that just as Lord Damodar is very dear to his devotees, so the month known as Damodar or Kartik is also very dear to them. Devotees observe vows and undertake austerities in the month of Kartik to please the Supreme Lord. The Padma Puran records the following statement of Sut Goswami. If anyone fasts and observes the Damodar Vrat, according to the rules and regulations, the Yamduts, that is, the messengers of Yamraj, run away from him. The performance of Damodar Vrat is better than performing 100 great sacrifices as prescribed in the Vedic scriptures. It is said that even a great heap of sins, as big as Mount Meru, also known as Sumeru Parvat, can be burnt down simply by offering a ghee lamp or a diya to Lord Shri Krishna or Radha Krishna, and the devotee is guaranteed with great benefits, both material and spiritual. He is guaranteed with devotion and a place in the personal abode of Shri Radha Krishna, which is Vaikunth. Lord Brahma told Narad Muni and Narad Ji told King Prithu for the welfare of mankind that the month of Kartik provides all four kinds of benefits, which are religious, economic, good marital life and enlightenment. One who hears the narration related to Lord Hari in this month becomes free from the sufferings of millions of births. Now, I will tell you about how to observe Kartik or Damodar Vrat. Everybody should perform these basic things in the month of Kartik. Wake up early in the morning and take a bath. The Padma Puran says, one who bathes early in the morning during the month of Kartik attains the merit of bathing in all places of pilgrimage. Next, chant at least one mala of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Devotees should try to do more Harinam chanting, do extra rounds and more kirtan. Hear Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita daily in association of exalted Vaishnavas, if possible. All other duties should be given up in favor of hearing the scriptures from the sadhus during this month. Cook varieties of vegetarian foodstuffs and offer to Lord Krishna. Eat only prasadam. You can optionally observe a fasting vow during this month. Gaudiya Vaishnavas fast from urad dal for the whole month of Kartik. In the Skand Puran, Lord Brahma informs Narad Maharishi, one should follow Kartik fast and listen to the narrations of Lord Shri Hari. Read the 9th and 10th chapter of the book Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, authored by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, which speaks about the pastime of Damodar in detail. A summary of the pastime is also given in this booklet. Next, perform Damodar Aarti. You can sing the Damodar Ashtak and offer a ghee lamp to Lord Damodar which is another name of Krishna. Anyone who offers a ghee lamp to Lord Shri Krishna or Radha Krishna in the month of Kartik will be freed from all kinds of sins and he will go to the abode of Lord Hari. Daily offer lamp to Tulasi Devi and pray for eternal residence in Vrindavan and eternal service of the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna. Associate more with devotees. Practice brahmacharya, that is celibacy. Perform austerities. Following are excerpts from some scriptures describing the glory of the pious Kartik month. If somebody performs even a little worship of Lord Shri Hari in this month, he offers that devotee his own abode. If somebody burns a lamp in the temple of Lord Shri Hari, even for a short time, in the month of Kartik, then whatever sins he has acquired for millions of kalpas are all destroyed. One kalp equals 1,000 yugas. A person who for the entire month of Kartik eats only once a day becomes very famous, powerful and heroic. A person who happily reads the Bhagavad Gita in the month of Kartik does not return to the world of birth and death. Of all gifts, the gift of a lamp during the month of Kartik is the best. No gift is its equal. The pious result obtained by following Kartik vow is 10 million times more than bathing in all holy places and giving all kinds of charities. One should limit one's senses and perform maximum austerity and also do cow seva, that is gau seva. One should sleep less and never do any kind of anger, ego or eat anything non-vegetarian or consume alcohol. Never envy other but spend mind, senses and body in maximum service of Radha Madhavji. Glories of offering ghee lamp in Kartik month. It is given in the Skanda Puran as per a conversation between Lord Brahma and sage Narad. If one offers a ghee lamp to Damodar in the month of Kartik, his sins of many thousands and millions of births perish. Even if no mantras are chanted, no pious deeds performed, and no purity observed, everything becomes perfect when a person offers a lamp during the month of Kartik. Offering a lamp to Lord Keshav in the month of Kartik is equivalent to performing all yajnas and bathing in all the holy rivers. When someone pleases Lord Keshav by offering him a lamp during the month of Kartik, then by the mercy of the Lord, the ancestors in the family will all attain liberation. To one who, either at home or in a temple, offers a lamp during this month, Radha Krishna gives great results. A person who offers a lamp to Lord Krishna during the month of Damodar becomes very glorious and fortunate. No sins exist anywhere in the three worlds that will not be purified by offering a lamp to Lord Keshav during Kartik. A person who offers a lamp to Lord Damodar during Kartik attains the eternal spiritual world where there is no suffering. Damodar Leela. Once when Mother Yashoda was feeding her lovely son Krishna, she noticed that the milk on the stove was overflowing. So she put Krishna down and went to attend to this. Left alone by his mother, Krishna became very angry and broke the pot of butter kept there for churning. He took the butter out of it and with false tears in his eyes, he began to eat the butter in a secluded place. Mother Yashoda sought Krishna all over. She found her son sitting on a big wooden grinding mortar kept upside down. On seeing his mother with a stick in her hand, Krishna got down from the grinding mortar and began to flee in fear. Mother Yashoda chased him to all the corners, trying to capture the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is never approached even by the meditation of great yogis. The Supreme Lord was playing just like a little child for such a great devotee as Mother Yashoda. Finally, Mother Yashoda caught Krishna. Krishna was almost on the point of crying. His eyes became restless from fear. Seeing that her son was fearful, Mother Yashoda threw away the stick. To punish him, she thought to bind him with ropes. She did not know that it is actually impossible for her to bind the Supreme Lord. When she tried to bind him, she found that the rope was always short by 2 inches. She gathered more ropes from the house and joined them, but still, she found the same shortage. In attempting to bind her son, she became tired. Then Lord Krishna appreciated the hard labor of his mother, and being compassionate upon her, he agreed to be bound up by the ropes. Krishna, playing as a human child in the house of Mother Yashoda, was performing his own selected pastimes. Of course, no one can control the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he agrees to be controlled by his pure devotees. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that the incident of Krishna's breaking the pot of yogurt and being bound by Mother Yashoda took place on Deepavali day. This pastime is elaborately described in the 9th chapter of the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. In the month of Kartik, one should worship Lord Damodar and daily recite the prayer known as Damodar Ashtak. Hare Krishna.
ऐसे ही और भक्तिमय कार्यक्रमों के लिए देखिए हरे कृष्णा टेलीविजन। इसे प्राप्त करने के लिए आप अपने केबल अथवा डीटीएच ऑपरेटर से संपर्क करें तथा और अधिक जानकारी के लिए आज ही डायल करें 8767 845 845।